morning, boys and girls. Teacher Shebi here from Vanden School. And today we are going to learn something in social studies. So, we are going to have social studies today. So, before teacher can get to start today's lesson, I'm going to take you back to what you learned last time. Last time, you were looking at road safety. You were looking at road safety. And I'm sure you are asking yourself, or maybe trying to remember what you learned about road safety. And here, I'm going to do something to help you remember exactly what you looked about under road safety. I'm drawing something on the board. Wow. I'm sure you're already guessing what I've done on the board. So, this is a robot or a traffic light. This is a traffic light or robots. And usually find this on the road, and it helps us know when to cross the road and when not to. It also guides the vehicles when they should stop and when they should drive. We also have this other road safety sign that you looked at, and already you are guessing also that this is a zebra crossing. This is a zebra crossing. And with this road sign, you find it on the road. You also find it on the road. Usually when you're crossing the road, we use this sign to cross the road. It guides us. Okay, so now, getting back to today's lesson, we are going to look at communication. We are going to look at communication. So now, communication means talking to people. It can be someone you're looking at or someone who is far. But in this case, we are going to look at how people a long time ago used to communicate. What things were they using to communicate to one another? So, that is our topic of discussion today. So, who can tell me anything they remember about communication? Or try to guess, what do you think people a long time ago used when they needed to communicate to one another? I'm sure you're already guessing. You're already guessing what they used. And with me here, I'm going to show you something to help you complete your guess on what people used a long time ago to communicate. Okay, so teacher has something there for you on the chart. On this chart, it is showing us things that people a long time ago used to communicate. And we are going to discuss picture by picture and also explain how each of the items that are on the chart were used. Okay, so which one are you going to start with? The drum. Good. We are going to start with a drum. So, with the drum, you know, a long time ago when a grandma for our fathers were there, they used a drum to communicate. I'm sure you're already debating that. How were they using a drum to communicate? Because this drum doesn't look like something that someone can use to communicate to other people. I'm going to show you how a drum was used back then to communicate. And guess what? I've got something here to show you. I'm going to lift it up and I'll put it here. Yes, you're right, this is a drum. So this drum that you're able to see here was used a long time ago to communicate to other people. And what they would simply do to communicate to people would be beating the drum. So whenever people heard this sound of a drum, then they would go and check what is happening. By them going to check out what is happening, the message was being passed to them. So if someone was to beat a drum a long time ago, people would come and watch them to see why are they beating a drum. And by doing so, communication was done. Oh no! From the drum, we also have another thing on the the chat. Another thing on the chat. So the next picture shows us fire. Yes, you're right again. This is the fire. But I'm sure you're wondering that, teacher Shelly, how was fire being used? I'm going to explain to you. Fire, imagine you're walking in the bush. It's dark. You don't even know where you're going. And you can't scream for someone to see where you are. So what people would do to show that there's someone where they are, they could light up fire. They could light up fire. Imagine it's dark and then you've made fire. So by making this fire in the bush or wherever people would be, other people would get attracted and see, why there's fire? I think there's someone else. There's someone there. Let's go and check. So by using fire, lighting up fire, that flame that you're seeing right here would attract the attention of people and they would run to see what is happening there. That was that about fire. And coming to this other interesting thing that looks like a box. What is this? Okay. This is a letter. So boys and girls, a long time ago when grandma, for mom and dad were born, in their time they had no cell phones. Or if they were there, there were no cell phones that anyone would have, a cell phone like this one. So people, in order to communicate to people from far away, for example, we are in Kasama and grandma needed to talk to someone who is in Osaka, they could write down what they want to say to their family, it could be friends. They would write it down and put it in an envelope and that will make up a letter. Then they'll go and take it. Maybe if they'll end up someone who's going to Osaka, then they'll give them, take this letter to whoever they want to send that message to. And that person will take the letter. But it used to take time because people had to wait for a letter to come using a letter. Those who had access to the post office, they could write a letter and take it to the post office. The people who work there would deliver the letter where it is going. That's how they used to communicate. Apart from this, there's one last more thing they used to communicate. So they used this. This is a horn. So with this, I'm sure you're wondering, but teacher, looking at the horn, how are they using it? What they could simply do was blow in air inside, and then it would make an interesting sound. How I wish I had one. I was going to show you how it was used. It was quite interesting. So when they blow air inside the horn, it would produce sound, and that sound that would come out, it would attract people. People would rush out. What is happening? Why is that one blowing the horn? And by doing so, the people who are blowing the horns would have communicated. Meaning people would go to them and they would want to know what is happening. So, this is how people of long time ago were using to communicate. Okay? So, they could use a drum, they could beat like this, loudly, not as not as soft as I'm doing it. It could be very loud. Then people get attention. Also the fire. They used fire to communicate to other people. A letter was sent, either taking to the post office or knowing about someone, going where they want to take the letter, they would give them to take the letter. And lastly, what you just looked at, they used a horn. They could sound a horn by blowing in air to communicate, and then people could come. So, these are some of the things that people of long ago used to communicate, okay? Old ways of communication. So now, teacher is going to do something. She's going to write something on the board. She's going to draw something on the board. And I expect you to do what it is going to do. So I'm going to write title here. I'm going to skip this line when letter Y is sitting and write the last word. It's quite long, you can't fit there, that's why I'm writing it here. So, I'm going to ask that you read with me what I've written here. You read the teacher. Old ways of communication. Old ways of communication. So, old ways of communication. Old ways of communication. Can you see that I've written my words? They are nicely sitting on the line. So, in writing a title, I expect you to write a title like this. So, now, teacher is going to make the drawings of who, the things that we talked about that were used to communicate a long time ago. Remember, when starting to write, follow what teacher is doing. I'm going to draw the things that were used to communicate. Okay, so here, teacher is going to draw. I hope you can see what teacher is drawing here. I hope you can see what teacher is drawing. Okay, and you're going to write the word here. You're going to write the word here. I can see already you're reading. So this is a drum. This is a drum. Apart from a drum, we also have this other word that was used to communicate a long time ago. I know you can do good drawings as a teacher. I'm looking forward to see how you're going to draw. Let's see who can draw better than teacher. Okay, so here we have fire. We have fire. So, remember we talked about four ways of communication. If I draw here, boys and girls, are you going to see it? Okay, we finished. So here I'm going to draw another way of communication that was used a long time ago. Okay, so here I'm going to write. See how teacher is writing? I expect you to write as neat as teacher. Okay. Expect you to write as neat as teacher. Okay, and lastly, what teacher talked about? Okay, so there we go. I'm also going to write. Teacher Shelby, get to see your fountain school. Thank you and bye-bye.